sorry for disturbing. So we defined the random variable part, okay? Now we go on to define the probability distribution of a random variable.
Probability distribution of a random variable.
So right now, what did we do? We said that, again, I'll have to maybe write the same. Three coins tossed. Sample space. S is HHH, HHT, HTH, THH, then HTT, THT, TTH, TTT. Correct? And we just saw if I define maybe
okay, so X HHH is X I define as number of heads. So we had seen that I have to maybe repeat this. X HHT is 2 X HTH is 2, XTHH is 2, X, HTT is 1, X, THT is 1, X, TTH is 1, X, TTT is 0.
Now, what are the values that it has taken? It has taken three distinct values, right? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Four distinct values, right? Sorry. So I may write this is the value of X. 0, 1, 2, 3. Now can you tell me what is the probability of getting 0?
1/8.
Getting a 0 is when it gets all tails, and that is half into half into half. So that is, see all of them have got the probability 1/8, right?
Yes.
All of them. So what is my probability of this? So here I am finding out probability of let me do this. What is the probability of getting HHH?
1/8.
That is 1/8. What is the probability of
getting 2HH?
Or I should say probability of 3. Probability of getting
1/8.
X as 3. So that is 1/8. Probability of getting X as 2.
3/8.
This is this or this or this gets added, 1/8, 1/8, so it is 3/8, okay, and I write it here. And what is the probability of getting the random variable as 1? That is 3/8. And what is the probability of getting this as 0? That is 1/8. Now, if you start writing it like this, 0, 1, 2, 3, and here you start writing your px, which is 1/8, 3/8, 3/8, 1/8. What should be the sum of this?
1.
Naturally. Because when you sum it, you are covering all the possibilities, right? This is called the probability distribution of a random variable. Okay? This is called the probability distribution of the random variable. Okay,
so this is called probability distribution of a random variable. So it looks like what? Here you have x, here you have px. So here you start writing x1, the values, these are the values of that, okay? X2, x3, maybe xn. Below that you start writing p1, p2, p3, pn. Okay.
Pn, such that the pi's are greater than 0 and summation pi is equal to 1.
Okay.
This is called the probability distribution of a random variable. So the case that we had just defined as the number of heads while tossing 3 coins, this is the probability distribution of that. Why we are doing that? We'll just see. Okay. So we first defined the random variable. Okay. Then we are defining the probability distribution of the random variable. Right. Now we'll go ahead. And this is how to solve it. Maybe you can solve a problem or two. Two cards are drawn successively with replacement from a well-shuffled deck of 52 cards. Find the probability distribution of the number of aces. Okay, so example, two cards drawn successively without replacement from a pack of cards. Find the probability distribution of the number of aces. So x is what?
0 over
2. X is the number of aces. And what values can it take?
0, 1, 2.
So x can take 0, 1, 2. Now what is px? We know that its output will always be a real number. Right? It has to be a real number. So what is px? Px, no aces. So there are how many aces in a card?
Four.
So there are how many non-aces?
48.
So you first pull a non-ace, that is 48 by 52, that is 12 by 13. Followed by that, you again pull a non-ace. Okay, so 12 by 13 into 12 by 13. Do we get that?
It's with replacement.
No, with replacement. What's the question that they have asked? With replacement?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so it is with replacement. So it is 12 by 13 multiplied by 12 by 13. So that becomes 144 upon 169. Pulling out one ace. No, the probability. So you pull out one ace, that is 4 by 52, that is 1 by 13, okay, into 12 by 13.
Sir, 1 by 4 nahi hoga
ace? Ace ka 1 by 4 hoga? Dusra. Nahi, 1 by 13 hoga. Kyun?
Ace ko chaar hi hota hai, 1 by 13, 4 mein se hi nikala.
To 4 out of 52 na?
4 by 52 is 1 by 13.
4 by 52, it's not 1 by 4. 1 by 4 will be when you have got all the 4 aces and you are drawing one ace out, okay. So it is, so it is 1 by 13 multiplied by a non-ace, so that is 12 by 13, so that is 12 by 169 plus, see either you draw, you draw and the first is an ace and the second is a non-ace, or what can happen?
You can either draw ace and non-ace or non-ace and ace,
or, so there are two ways.
So ace, this is 1 by 13 into 4 by 13, or is plus, that's an alternate sum rule, plus 12 by 13 plus 12 by 13 into 1 by 13. So that is actually 24 by 169.
You get it? Right? See, you have to draw only one ace and you are drawing twice. So either it is that there are two ways in which you can get that, no? Suppose I draw first and I get a non-ace. Then I draw and then I put that card back. Then I draw and I get an ace. So that is one of the ways of getting it, which is this. Or it can so happen that the first card that I draw is an ace and put it back and then I draw a non-ace. So ace and non-ace, or non-ace and ace. So there are two ways in which you can do that. Everyone gets that? So, and what is drawing out two aces?
1 by 13
into 1 by 13. So that is 1 by 169. Do they sum to 1? They do. They do. Always do check that. Otherwise, it will be wrong. Because we say summation pi is 1. Okay. So we understand what the probability distribution is. Okay.